There it is, Trump Tower, home of a very successful business owner. And yet in today's world, people are becoming more successful faster as long as they know the secrets of how to become a successful business owner. And today, I'm going to share those secrets with you. Won't you follow me into the jungle? Hey, what's up? Chris Krohn here. I'm in Las Vegas. This is my presidential suite, and I'm teaching ninjas, people just like you, how to do business at the most successful level. Because the reality is, there's only a little bit of training that makes the difference between whether you make $50,000 a year like the average entrepreneur, or whether you make millions of dollars like some of the most successful. Listen, if you want to understand how to make a lot of money in business, you should at least understand first, what really is a business? From Investopedia, they say, a business is defined as an organization or enterprising entity engaged in commercial, industrial, or professional activities. Or maybe said in an easier way, you basically provide products and services that people want, and you as an organization build them and fulfill them. Businesses can be for-profit entities, they can be nonprofit organizations. There are various forms of business, such as limited liability companies, a sole proprietorship, a corporation, and a partnership. And businesses can range from small operations operating in one industry to large operations operating in many industries around the world. Listen, business, in truth, can be super complex. Today though, I'm gonna make it a lot simpler than this. In fact, I wanna talk to you about what I call turnkey business, meaning how do I find and start a business that makes a lot of money that one day I can sell for a big pile of money or hold on to and just keep cash flowing. But what's the point of me sharing the secrets of successful business if you're too scared to start one? The reality is there's a lot of risk to going into business for yourself if you don't know what you're doing, if you're not subscribed to channels like this where I'm teaching you how to do it successfully. And the reality is the problem with being a business owner is that if you do it wrong, you can end up working a lot harder, sometimes for less money. And that's because there's a key distinction between someone who owns a business and gets paid from that business and someone who operates that business and gets tired working in that business. Man, when I got into business for myself, I thought being in business meant working and making a lot of good money, and that was kind of the end of the story. I was actually becoming an operator instead of an owner. And I want you to understand that there's a difference, because that first month, I was making a lot of money, and I was also working really hard, but I felt really good about the trade. 2 months later, however, the money stopped coming in, and so I started working even harder, but then I wasn't even getting paid. And that's when I understood there's a difference between owning a successful business and being an operator. Owners can get rich, they can be successful, but operators, they get tired because they're the ones trapped in the business. If you're gonna be into business for yourself, rule number one, you don't wanna be the one operating the business, at least not after the initial phase. You want other people to do that so that you have money and you have time. I'm gonna show you what that looks like. You need to decide what kind of business owner you want to be. Do you want to be an operator that gets tired, or do you want to be a successful owner of multiple businesses? Check out these facts from Fundera. They say that the average small business owner with no employees has an average annual revenue of $46,978 a year, which is basically what the average American makes at a job. But on top of that, 86.3% of small business owners make less than $100,000 a year, and it's only 2% that make $1 million on up. So you should be asking yourself, Chris, what are the standards that you use in getting into a business that allows you to be part of the 2% club where you can make over $1 million a year versus struggling to make 50K? You see, the biggest reason why people fail in business is because they don't have standards. Standards are like rules that you set for your life that you don't violate. For example, I'm married, I got 4 kids, and I made a promise to my wife that I'm not gonna sleep around with other women, I don't cheat. If I break that rule, there's gonna be some really nasty negative consequences. Well, in business, no one goes into business with anyone telling them what the rules are. So what I wanna do is I wanna share with you 5 specific rules, And these are the rules that not only have kept me out of trouble, they've actually allowed me to make a lot of money. Rule number one, pick a business where you have a lot of leftover money after all of the expenses are paid. That's called margin. And I like to have high margin businesses. That basically means that for every dollar of revenue or money that comes in from something being sold, that I get to keep maybe 20, 30, or 40 cents of it at the end of the day. Did you know that the typical company has a 10% margin? That means $1 comes in and they get to keep a dime. Now I look at that and that smells like a whole lot of work and not really having a lot to keep at the end of the day. But if you could find a business that had double the margin, you'd have to work half as hard. So for me, I find businesses with really good margins so that I work a lot less to make even more money. Rule number two, your business is only going to be successful if you have people that you can offer your products and services to. Those are called prospects or sometimes leads. And when I'm looking at building a business or buying a business, here's my question. Does this business come with a lot of leads or very few leads? If it's hard to sell your product to people and there's only a handful of people that might want your product, I'm not going to be interested in that business because you can only make a lot of money if you have a lot of people that you can sell stuff to. So I'm looking for a business that has an abundance of qualified leads. And if it doesn't, I'm out.
I'm out.
I'm out.
I'm going to go back in. And for that reason, I'm out.
I'm still out.
The third rule of killing it in business, I learned from Tony Robbins. For a couple of years, I spent hundreds of thousands of dollars. I learned from him. And I remember when he taught me this one thing. He said, complexity is the enemy of execution. Or in other words, if something is complicated, it's easier to screw up. It's easier for people to not do it right. And so in business, what I've learned is the simpler the business, the better the business. There might be other people that try to compete with you because it's so simple, but if you're committed to being the best that you can be at that business, then simplicity is gonna serve you. If I can train you in one day how to do a job in this business versus 3 months, guess what? It's gonna be easier for me and you to create success. Years ago, I had a business that was crazy complicated and it took months to train people. And you know what I learned from doing that? It was really hard to make money. But since then, I've tried a variety of ultra simple businesses. In fact, if you click the link below, I'll share 50 different business ideas for simple businesses that make me the most money. Simple is where it's at. You know, anytime I'm looking for a lot of creativity to explode my business to the next level, I come to Vegas. It's such a curious place. It has so many strange and bizarre things like this gold shell. The fourth secret to being successful in business is you have to outsource. You have to delegate and hand things off to somebody else. Here's where most people get stuck as operators in business, is they got excited about some idea, then they started creating it, then they started selling it, then they started fulfilling it. Before you know it, they got lost in their own business thinking that the goal was to be passionate and put all this time in. For me, you're not gonna see me do a single job in my company for longer than 4 months before it's been handed off to somebody else so that I can move on to bigger and better. The next secret is to beware of passion and pioneering. Passion causes people to get so excited about the product when they're supposed to be excited about the customer and they get stuck trying to make the product better. They get lost in their own business. Your goal is to found a business and start a business, learn how to do it and then hand it off to somebody else. And if you've got great margins, you can hand it off and make a lot of money. So passion's not bad, but it can be weaponized against you. Likewise, be careful about pioneering, meaning you're gonna bring some new idea to the marketplace that no one's ever done before. Usually that costs a lot of money and you gotta be super fast before someone steals that idea from you, or there's a reason why the idea has never been done before. It's kind of a dumb idea. Pioneering can get you in trouble, so can passion. Hey, while I've got you, let me share a sixth bonus secret for today's video. I don't ever start a business without knowing the end in mind. In other words, I'm asking myself, what is the exitability of this business? Am I building a business that is an asset that grows? You know I love real estate. I'm always buying real estate, and that's because it's an asset that grows. business is actually a lot like real estate. If you do it right, it's an asset that you build over time, and you should be able to sell it or at least make a lot of cash flow as long as you're holding on to it. So ask yourself, is this business built around me and my unique attributes and my personality, or is this an idea that someone else can run with and I could step away and it could go on to become really successful? If the business requires you, it may not be a good idea. If on the other hand, you can step away, that means you have an exitable business. Hey, thanks for watching today's video. If you liked what you learned today, make sure you subscribe because I got a lot more coming your way. If you're watching this video and thinking, man, Chris, it sounds like you really know what's up and down and you know how to judge a good business. I go through for fun and I judge businesses to find my favorite ones and the very best ones. And I have a list of recommendations in the link below of my top 50 favorite all-time businesses. Click the link and see what kind of businesses I think are smart, that are super profitable and don't take a lot of time. And if you like some of those, copy them and do them yourself. Hey, thanks for watching today's video. If you want to live it up large and have crazy amounts of success and see how I've helped other people do it, click the link below, check out this video. You're going to see him kill it in business. Here we go! Ah!